treat me like you love me, Mum. You treat me like what I am. A constant reminder of the day you will...
I love you.
Cheers.
Queen.
Every year we wrapped one, just in case, and saved them all.
And we promised ourselves if you ever came back, hey, this is a happy day.
I don't know where to start.
Well, you've got all day. There's no rush. Why don't you give your dad a big hug? That's a good place to start.
Having you back is the best present ever.
You all right? Oh, yeah, I forgot. Here you go. Happy Christmas.
Wait, you did it.
It's outside.
Get it!
Oh, nice one. And I got you a new contract, which is good for international calls.
Wait, am I missing something?
I was going to wait for Diane to get back from her mum tonight. Here you go. It's your next present. Well, it's not really a present, but you know what I mean. I saw it arrive and I had to take a look. It's an acceptance letter from the University of California.
The scholarship came through.
Now, obviously, we don't want you to go away, but... Well, this is once-in-a-lifetime stuff. You know, the chance to study abroad, play football at a decent level. This is a fresh start, Harry. This is your ticket to a better life. What do you say?
You've had a look everywhere. What more do you want?
They're not coming back. Not today.
They know they're not welcome here. And neither are you. So go on, get out.
Off. It's you with your lanky legs.
It's you with your bony bum.
Enough! Right, you need to stop this. And you're not coming out of here until you've sorted it. I mean it!
No!
Wait!
Let us out! Oh. Myra!
Good one.
Merry Christmas. Oh. What happened to you?
Well, you know, it was Christmas Eve, wasn't it? I had a few too many, fell down some steps. I never could handle me snowballs, could I?
You actually drink those?
Well, you got to get in the festive spirit, ain't you?
But you're okay, you're not going to die or anything.
No, not before the Queen's speech. Hey, go on, kiss one of them.
You're nailed by mouth. And it is such a shame because...
They are so good.
Tegan?
Merry Christmas.
Portia, I want to prove how serious I am, how much I want to go away. Look, give me a call back when you get this. I need to come and see you.
Want to tell me what you're doing?
I'm getting out of here. You're leaving? With Portia, hopefully. Who might stand in your way?
Is that why you went away? To get me this?
Yeah, sort of. But listen, it may not look like much, but what it lacks in power, it makes up for in fuel economy.
Which makes you sound so cool.
I've got to go and talk to Teresa. Can I nip round there quickly?
You're not driving?
Come on.
You can walk round there for 10 minutes. He's a man in love.
Yeah? Nice one.
Pace, come on. We can go.
You need to talk to Ziggy.
Say what?
I don't know. How about starting with thank you?
Harry.
No. Ziggy, she's got something she wants to say to you.
No, I haven't. Fine. You are a dirty, lying, cheating...
Mum.
Thanks in that. Glad you were there.
Don't worry, it's nothing.
You are kidding. You saved a life.
I don't know about that, miss.
You did. Thank you. Oh. Well, isn't this cosy?
Merry Christmas!
Now's not a great time. There's a bit of a situation going on here.
Yeah, then come to mine if you like. Bring the kids.
Kathleen Angel, she's been up all night. Like, she's been a bit of a nightmare, so...
Do I at least get a Christmas kiss?
I better get back inside.
Teresa, I don't get this.
What? There's nothing to get. It's just family.
It's more than that. I thought we were... tight, you know? I told you I loved you.
Yeah. And I've realised that I think maybe I've just been leading you on.
Then forget I said it. It was stupid. I didn't mean it. This isn't love. It's whatever you want it to be.
I want it to be over.
You hit your head. You're supposed to be going for a scan.
Yeah, not until you've heard me out.
What is it to say? You lied about where you were last night because you went looking for Leela.
I mean, you're still married. I guess getting back together is cheaper than a divorce.
I know you were miserable with Leela being away and that and Perry not being at home. But I went round there to talk to him.
Teagues, he is telling the truth. Look, he just wanted us to come home.
Teagan, please. I love you.
Don't say words that you don't mean. If I let you back into my life, I get my heart broken. And that is not happening again.
But something happened.
I just made a total mug of myself. She dumped me.
Okay, get out of the car.
You said I would get hurt. Well, here it is, Lisa. I'm hurting.
Just forget about Teresa. Let's go back inside.
No. That might be Teresa.
Watch out!
Si! Yeah. So, what time are you heading over to Archway?
One. We said one. I just really hope he turns up.
Are you sure this is what you want?
Yeah, of course it is.
He's hurt you so much in the past. Do you love him? I mean, do you really love him? Or are you doing this because you're scared of being on your own? Or you've got something to prove?
Come on, don't get yourself all upset. You don't need to worry, OK? It's me. Sensible me.
I know you say you're not like us McQueens.
Never said that.
Like, because you talk proper and... and you know where your apostrophes go and everything. But when it comes to falling in love, you are a car crash. Just like the rest of us.
Yeah, you got me there. Can't really argue. Look, I know it's a risk, and he might not even turn up, but I've just got this buzz, you know? And if he's there under the archway and it all goes to plan, then it's gonna be perfect. Come here, you daft mare. Look, all I want for Christmas is Steve.
So I just can't turn up there all casual and that, you know. We'll have a little chat and suggest we see how things go. Because once I'm under that archway, bang, that is it. Right, married again, back to where we were, living together forever. Thank you very much. Amen.
I'm getting a bit confused here, mate.
Well, yeah, because you've just checked yourself out of hospital. Plus, that is your second snowball. Shouldn't even be drinking if you've got a head injury.
Or perhaps I just don't understand gay love.
You don't have to call it gay love, it's just love, innit?
From where I'm sitting, your life couldn't be simpler. If you love him, go.
If not,
well, you can just sit here with me and have another drink. Whereas my life...
You're the one that's got it simple.
Oh, yeah, Tegan won't even speak to me. She says it will never happen.
Of course it will, she absolutely loves you.
Really?
Obsessed. She's just being a stubborn cow right now because you've hurt her, that's all. Listen, the bigger the hurt, the bigger the gesture you have to do to get over it.
I've got just a thing.
So I'm thinking, hotel, get ourselves a donkey, three wise men, proper little Christmas story.
Why do we have to go anywhere? I'm not saying that you've got to forgive him straight away, but you know you will eventually. And this is our home.
Yeah. Look, Ziggy, he's...
So what? He was in love with Tiga when you married him. But you were in love with Cameron. And deep down, you know that's the truth. And he's not with Celine anymore, so...
Pez, just stop it.
Why can't we just stay?
Only place with a shop that's open on Christmas Day. It's like people want to spend it with their families or something. What happened to you? You guys all right?
Just a matter of our flat exploding.
Yeah, police are investigating. You know, if we were inside, I can't even think about it.
Police, did they think of something dodgy?
Routine thing.
And have you guys seen Cameron? It's just, I know he wanted to see you, Perry, and had a present for you.
No, he didn't know where we were, did he?
No, he didn't. And I don't want him knowing Lockie.
Oh, don't worry, I'm on your side. Believe me.
What have I done? Look, Mum's gonna kill me.
Too right she will.
It wasn't his fault. The car seemed to skid and the brakes locked up.
I told you not to drive it.
What is it with you and cars? I thought you were ready for the responsibility.
Were you even paying attention?
Of course he was.
I'm gonna have to call the council. Probably the police.
Oh, it was an accident.
They still need to know.
Okay, we'll deal with this. You take the car to the Roscoe place. I think they're open on Boxing Day. Lisa, you drive. I've had a drink.
Fine, but come straight home.
Offer accepted. You'll be California dreaming until September. Next stop, Hotel California.
Tell you, all those California girls better watch out.
Boys, sorry, California boys. It's just a song lyric thing.
Yep, got it, Dad. Thanks.
Here you go, put your new number in here.
Wait, I'll just call you so you got it.
Add it to the contact list. I'm going to check on the old bird. No, I don't mean Diane. Well, I do think she would have called me by now. Seems quiet, just the pair of us.
Wait, hold on, Dad. Wait, the police?
Harry, wait.
Wait, it was you, wasn't it? Look, you grassed on Steve.
He's the one with the drugs. He's only got himself to blame.
He said he wasn't going to use them.
Well, that's what addicts always say.
Well, so he wasn't going to flush them, hmm? No, he was lying about that, was he? Look at me and tell me the truth.
Okay, this time he was, but next time...
You stitched him up!
I was trying to stop you from getting hurt!
Hurt? I was in love.
Oh, Harry, you're 18, you don't know what love is.
Look, he was the man I wanted to spend the rest of my life with. And now you've trashed everything. Telling me you disapprove, that's one thing. Offering me your advice, maybe that's okay, but getting him arrested... You are the worst father I could ever have. The way you're always trying to control me. Now, I've had enough. I'm not going to let you do it to me anymore.
You call yourself a mum? You're an absolute jerk!
You stop it! It's Christmas Day!
Oh, sorry if I'm not feeling very festive.
Can you just give her a break for 1 second?
Me?
Okay. Yeah, so she could have gone about this in a totally different way. Spoken to you and tried to make you understand.
Yeah, she could.
Look at her. None of this was about hurting you. So just back off. And sort it out, the pair of you.
Oh.
Please tell me you didn't do it.
You've lost me.
You know, it all makes sense now.
That's why you wanted me out of the picture. You knew I'd work it out. When I find Leela, I'm gonna kill her. That's what you said. Did you rig up that flat and try and blow it up?
I don't have to listen to this.
What happened to you? When you got out of prison, you were a man desperate to get back with his family. I looked up to you. I respected you. Now you're hiding out here. You do know they're investigating.
Well, they won't find anything.
Because you covered your tracks.
No, because I didn't do it.
You've got 2 hours to clear out. Before I call the police and I tell Leela and Perry what kind of monster you are.
Come on.
I mean it! 2 hours.
You should have admitted it to me years ago that you hated me. That you couldn't look at me without seeing him.
That is not true.
Off the lion, mother! You hate me then and you hate me now. Because of him.
Okay, fine. When I found out I was pregnant, I felt dirty. I know I didn't want you. Nobody wanted you.
I knew it. I knew it.
Until I felt your kick. That's when it all changed. That's when it went from something he'd done, a reminder of all that hurt and pain, to this wonderful and amazing thing. You know, when I first gave birth to you and I held you in my arms, I knew no one had ever take you away from me. They tried. They told me I should be ashamed of you. But I fought for my little girl. And I won. I felt like it was my fault. That I'd encouraged Derek, that I'd led him on. And that I deserved what he did to me. And that's what you told me. And I was stupid enough to believe him.
You wasn't stupid, Bob. You were scared.
If I could have told someone. But I couldn't talk. I didn't know how to say it. And I didn't think anyone would want to listen. And by the time you're old enough to really understand, it was too late. Or at least I thought it was. Please let me be the mum I've always wanted to be.
So this is it then. We're doing this.
Can't live without you. Drive, rubbish. So.
Don't do the knee thing.
I'm doing the knee thing. I'm doing the knee thing. Steve McQueen. Will you be my husband? Again.
Killed each other. I'm just saying.
Mum's explained a few things.
What about the police? You've broken the conditions of your bail. It's been on the radio and everything. They're not going to stop looking for you.
You always knew I'd end up back inside, love. They're not getting through that door again today. They can't arrest her if they can't find her. You've held onto that secret for so long, Mum. I can't imagine what it's done to you.
must have eaten you up inside. You never stood a chance. We never stood a chance. Look, Lockie has made me realise that I just want to get out of here. And I want to start again somewhere fresh. I want you to come with me, Mum.
Sucks so much. I always knew she was out of my league.
No one is out of your league.
And why did she dump me?
Because she's stupid.
I'm stupid.
Zach! Wait! Zach, don't say that.
I hate this. People are going to think that I'm such a fool for even thinking that a girl like her...
What she did, that's her problem. You are amazing and kind and good. You must know how much everyone loves you, how much I love you.
I love you too. What are you doing?
Sorry.
What, Lisa? I don't...
Forget it. Forget it ever happened. I just got confused about who you were.
You pissed me.
It was a mistake. Just pretend I didn't do it or something.
But are you serious? Pretend? Like, this is disgusting. Like, I mean, what are you doing? You're my sister.
No! No! It doesn't have to be like that. I mean, we're not... You say it's disgusting, but only if you knew.
You're not making any sense, Lisa.
No, I'm not Lisa!
What?
I'm not your sister. I'm not Lisa Loveday.
Who are you?
My name's Sonia, and everything I told you was true. I was living on the streets. You know where I came from and the life I had.
Do you think that makes this okay?
No, of course not. But I was desperate. I didn't know when I was going to eat again. Or when I would spend a night in the warm without that fear of being attacked or forced into some bloke's bedroom. What I was doing, the way I was living my life, ripping you guys off, it felt like the easy option.
This was about the money.
At first.
We took you in. We showed you nothing but love.
And that's why I stayed. I came looking for money, but I got a family. A mum and dad who loves you, TV dinners on the sofa, talking and laughing. That was real, I promise you.
Do you know what you sound like? Like, do you know what you've done? How? How did you know all that stuff about Lisa?
I met her when I was younger. She told me about her life, and when I saw you in the paper, I knew you were...
So you know where she is?
Not anymore.
But all this time, we could have been out there looking for her.
Oh, no!
You're evil! You have to be. Anyone that can sit there and watch us go through that has to be. I'm calling Mum. I'm going to the police.
No, no, wait. You don't understand. I lied to protect you from the truth.
What are you talking about?
Your real sister. She's dead.
Big gesture. Come on. You can do this. You're a man. Just don't look down. Don't do this! Don't freak out!
What do you think you're playing at?
I think I'm stuck! Just call the fire brigade!
I was just in shock. That's all. Come on, John Paul, my head is so wrapped up in you and me. Yeah, you know, we were there and you were doing the whole down on one knee thing, you know, I wasn't expecting to see you.
Stop it. You're embarrassing yourself. You love him.
No.
Well, you don't love me. Actually, you know what? I think you do love me.
Yeah.
You turned up today, wearing your suit.
Scrub up all right, don't I?
We both do. No, I think we should probably make a go of this. You know? After everything that we've been through, all the times that we've dragged each other out of the gutter, and we're still here, we're still smiling. You know? We turned up today, and if that's not love, then I don't know what is.
Right, so what's the problem then?
I married my best mate.
And what, that's a bad thing?
Well, it is when your best mate's a randy little scally like you, yeah.
Oi!
No, it's not a bad thing, it's a good thing. It's an amazing thing. We deserve excitement. You know, we deserve heart-stopping, passionate love. Now, didn't I give you that? Now and then you did, yeah. Settle for friendship over love. Not yet. Okay. Find someone that makes your heart flutter. You've only got one life.
To woo the ladies.
It's topical, all right? I had my costume sitting around here with a sack full of presents.
And what are we going to do? Stuff them down our blocked-up chimney?
I don't know. It was a spur of the moment thing, wasn't it?
How many times? Spur. It's spur of the moment.
Oh, whatever. You say potatoes, I say hurry up with that ladder, will ya?
By the way, madam.
With pleasure.
Hey, what's with the electricity off? You ruined that Christmas dinner, you do know that.
Well, I kind of got my own problems at the moment here, mate. Please just hurry up.
Matt, let me get this one.
Catch.
You can't do this. Abandon Cleo. Well, there's trial coming up. I'm sorry. I need to leave.
Pusher. I'm not sure I'm in the right headspace to deal with your mother. I've got my own stuff going on with Cameron.
Do you love me? Do you want to be with me?
You know I do.
Then great, she's coming.
No! Look, I don't want your drunken mother coming along. Ever since we've been here, your family's got in the way.
Yeah, because you keep sleeping with them.
Oh, before all that, look at the dramas, the arguments. I can't cope with your mother. I just want you.
Marry me and marry my family. That's the deal. Look, I'm a McQueen. We shout, we scream, and we fight until we get what we want. And this is what I want. A chance to finally get to know my mum after all these years.
Don't we deserve the chance?
We've had it. Time and time again. And I am all yours. But it's the package deal, I'm afraid.
Come on, I've got you.
Oh.
Now follow me down.
Okay.
You've got a fantastic bum, by the way.
You what?
I just think it's about time we start being honest with each other. Got a great bum. Listen, though, this doting puppy dog thing and the fake tan and the modelling career that isn't actually a modelling career and the conversations that start with, oh, the thing I love about banana bongos is...
What, the way the milk don't turn yellow? But it always tastes like bananas. Yeah, I've always wondered how they do that.
Yeah, and I couldn't care less. But you and me, we were always going to end up divorced, weren't we? But you and Tegan, might just have a chance.
Not anymore. I think I've blown it this time.
I don't know. Why don't you let me give it one last go?
Listen, darling, can I give you a call back? Okay.
I don't want to talk about Steve, and I'm only here because I've got nowhere else to go.
Steve, call me back when you get this. We've got no power, so I'm thinking we head to the dog.
In your room at the inn.
So, is this it then? You're gonna spend the rest of your life running from police?
There's no other way.
There has to be. This isn't what we wanted. I wanted to fix his family and for us all to be together.
I've hurt Porsche for so many years. This is my chance to put it right.
Mum, inside now. We could go out the back and over the alley.
Can pick up Lockie on the way, come on.
Will you please just stop? I don't want you to go to prison, but losing you forever.
Please, come on, we've got to go. I'm sorry, we've got to go.
Mum, I thought I had the best stepdad in the world. And with him, I could be angry at you. For drinking. And letting me down over and over. And I didn't need you. But Pete's gone now.
Darling.
And I know what he is. It's just now, more than ever, you know, with the trial coming up. I really need my mum.
Renee.
Having a jailbird for a mum. It's better than having no mum at all. It's all right. Get your man and you'd live your life.
Greenie McQueen, I'm arresting you for assaulting a police officer.
I told you to go.
I know you did.
Like, I'm trying to start again, get my life back on track. Why don't you do the same? You know, this place has been nothing but bad for us. I nearly wrecked everything, but you, ah, the pain you've caused. You tried to kill Leela, so go. I mean it. Or I'll tell him what you did.
No, you won't. You're not going to say a word.
Ziggy, it's not quite the dinner I was planning, and I'm not one to stand on ceremony. Okay, I'm totally one to stand on ceremony, but here I am with my son at the table. Even though we got a lot to work through, I count myself lucky. That's all I wanted to say. I made a mistake, I know that. I made a few in my time.
Please don't mention Sinead.
Hey, I wouldn't dream of it. But I would like to raise a toast to sticking together and working things out. And always, always having cold meats in the fridge. What do you want?
Hurry, please. I can't live without you. I saw you with John Paul.
No, it's not happening.
Well, so you just thought you'd just come running back to me.
It's not happening because of you, Harry.
Please.
Look, I know it doesn't make any sense at all. Okay, and I know that I am a massive, massive risk. Look, I'm only saying all of this because... Right, I've been an addict. And without someone like you by my side, then... I slip right back there.
Look, wait. Look, I know you were throwing the drugs away. Okay, it was Daddy stitched you up.
Yeah, I know. But I don't blame him. I would do exactly the same if it was my kid. And yet, my track record is a complete, utter mess of messes. And you will be majorly wrong in the head to go for me.
You got that right.
But please, please go for me?
I guess we could give it a try.
What? Really?
Yeah. No way. It's not happening. No way you're under my roof.
It's not going to be under your roof. It'll be under mine.
What?
If that's what you want.
Yeah.
You know, this thing with me and Ziggy, it's totally over now.
Tegan, if you didn't love him, what's it all about?
Please, come on. Look, the guy dresses up as Santa and your heart don't melt. I mean, personally, I think he's a complete idiot. But do you know what? That's not even an opinion. He is actually a complete idiot. Climbing up a drain pipe. You know what you need to go after Ziggy? Especially before he kills himself in the next stupid stunt. You are more important to me than any man.
I know. And I'm back. For Perry. And for Mum and Dad. And for me. Just a little bit.
I have missed you so much.
I know.
But listen, you really need to get Ziggy back before it's too late.
I've been looking for you everywhere. Have you told them?
I wouldn't know where to start. The fact that their daughter, my sister's dead.
Look at this. She was never coming back.
And you stop.
The only link she had to you guys is she gave it away because she wasn't looking for Louis and Simone. She had a family around her. She was happy.
She'd never have worn that.
I know you think I'm evil, but you gave me a family and now I'm here. Now they believe me. It'll rip them up inside.
Stay away from me. Yeah, they're strong. Yes, it will crush them, but with the new baby on the way, they can focus on that. They don't need you.
I won't let them down. I promise. Please, don't do this to them.
Ziggy, come see me. When I was in the hospital before the operation, I called you. Do you remember? I held up that bit of paper, told you, congratulations. Well, it was the wrong message. I'm at the flat.
Was the best thing that ever happened to you for good.
Nah, forget him. Seriously, he's had his chance. Do you know what? I spent far too much time forgiving him already.
So you're gonna go on your own?
Yeah.
It's not like I ever needed a man to make me happy, is it?
Tell me about it.
Stay. Just for a bit. Please.
Don't. Do you have any idea what it's taken me to walk out of here? To leave you both.
We'll be all right.
I just need to get away. Sort my head out. I need to start again. No, my time is here.
Now listen. You. You're the bravest little girl I've ever known. And don't ever forget that, all right, kiddo? Come here.
Yeah, I'll get some of this hubby's mark on you.
Beautiful and thoughtful.
They're good kids.
Is it our fault? Did we do something?
Of course not.
The arguments we had last week, the stress we were under.
No, no. You can't think like that.
Something made me lose our baby.
Hey, it's no one's fault.
And the fact that I had doubts, we questioned whether or not this was the right time.
You stop that now, please. You think about Mercedes. That poor woman carrying a baby for 9 months.
I know what she went through compared to this.
That's not what I meant. I was asking, would you blame her? Would you ever even think for just a second that she did anything to deserve it?
Of course not.
And if she was here now, heartbroken, looking for answers, what would you tell her? What would you say?
You did nothing wrong.
Exactly. Neither did we.
Zach, no, please.
Mum, Dad, this. What's happened?
Your mother and I have got some difficult news. When we went away to your grand's, we lost the baby.
It's okay. I'm okay. It's going to be hard, but we're strong. And we have been blessed in so many ways. But it's okay to feel sad. We've got so much love and joy in our lives, and we'll use that to get us through.
Hey, up, Piz.
No. I'm not singing, it's Super Jesus.
Oh, come on, Scrooge, everyone's singing. There you go, get that, Daniel.
Oh, it's like sugar in a glass.
Christmas in a glass. Now, come on, everyone, let's get it started, eh? And...
Deck the halls with boughs of holly.
Got your message. If you don't want me here, that...
No. I know that you're a good person, but what you did wasn't. I want my mum to be happy.
Thank you.
It's cool.
Look, I know we both said some things and, well, you made your point really clear.
I miss you. I really miss you.
Then come here.
I must have just cut myself shaving.
Happy Christmas. Ziggy? 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 Ziggy, come here. You can't be dead. Get me an ambulance! No, come on. No. No. Please don't leave.
You know, if you'd like support for issues that came up tonight, there's information and phone numbers with links to sites that could help at channel4.com/support. And the Oaks is back here on Monday night at 6:35.